good idea for you to go to, for one of you guys to go to the end and see if it's working okay in the first, you know, first five boxes.
Yeah, it's
wonderful. I gave it a good test. All right. Hello, welcome to Lakeside Lanes in Manchester, New Hampshire, where it's 52 degrees and raining outside, but inside it, weather is perfect for a doubles championship. $2,400 is on the line here as we have Mark Ricci and Jeff Walsh from Riverwalk Lanes facing off against Keith Beaupre and Daniel Chouinard representing the Metro Bowl. It's the Battle of Essex County up here in New Hampshire. Jeff Walsh will bowl first. We're going to be bowling a five-string doubles match. Expect scores around $2,400. And he starts it with a hammer. The eight was the last to fall. Beaupre is off wide left. Jeff Walsh, and sees very pleased with that beginning. Beaupre, this third ball here in the first. Found the pocket with that second one. A 10. So right off the bat, this today's format, five strings for each of the bowlers. So again, we'll see scores with these guys. These guys' averages are all around 117 to 120. Walsh with the first bonus ball leaves a 3-1. Late action for Keith. He's got the triangle, a little side saddle triangle with the head pin in front. 7 in the bonus, so 17 start for Jeff Walsh and a 7-pin lead. Spare for Beaupre. And an 8 for Walsh. Walsh lives in Rutland, Mass. 37 years old. Finds the pocket, leaves the side saddle. 4 in the fill, so it's a 1-pin game right now. Very early going here. There's a spare. Second mark out of 3 for Walsh. Late pin action, but Beaupre will be open. 2 tens and a spare with a 4 fill for Beaupre. He's at 34. Jeff Walsh had a strike with a 7 fill, an 8, and a spare, and this bonus ball. Nine drop. Beaupre is in the pocket, but leaves a 2-1. 44-34 through 3. No. His mouth is open. He's surprised. He had a read on that. Didn't work out. That was the read. 10 for Walsh. 54 through 4, 14 over, 42 through 4 for Keith, Jeff Walsh and Mark Ricci came here by way of, we originally started with 32 bracket style. He drops 7 on his first ball with the head pin. Beaupre has a 9 drop with the 7 remaining. And pin zone is out in the deadwood zone. Oh, perfectly executed. Took out the 1, the 3, and the ball and the pin. Carried the 10. So 64 and a ball to start for Jeff Walsh. Keith Beaupre staring down a single pinner here. Nope. That'll be a 9. That was in the channel. 51, huh? So that's an early 13 plus a ball. So starting us off on lane 6, Mark Ricci from the Riverwalk team. Ricci, 39, has a league average of 117, but his average in this lately has been 127.6 in this tournament, in the last two rounds anyway. He bowls, he's the proprietor, owner and proprietor of Riverwalk. He bowls in the Monday Singles League. He'll be open in the first. Chouinard on the left for Metro. Can't push the four horsemen down, leaves head in. Okay, 10 for Chouinard. Ricci with that four step. It's a 9 drop with a leader, with a guide. Ricci has a 72% accuracy on his objects. And that one goes according to Hoyle. Chouinard also picks up the two pinner. A little more difficult there. Chouinard is a 74% accuracy. He throws a different contrasting styles here. Chouinard throws the ball 25 to 27 miles per hour on his measured strikes. Ricci actually surprising. He actually brings the ball way up high and generates a surprising run. His strikes have been clocked at 34 miles an hour. Deceptively fast there. 5 in the fill for Ricci and 6 in the fill for Chouinard. The team out of Riverwalk has an early 13 pin lead plus a ball. Off his eye right there. Chouinard throws a 2-6 Cobras and moves the ball right to left. Gets a lot of action on the roll. He really relies on the spin. That's a 10 for Ricci on the horseman. Nice 10 for both gentlemen. Good pro 10s. I'm going to ask him if maybe the music can come down just a notch. Yeah. Tournament director, Nick Zuffoletto, to my right. See if we can reduce the ambience music in the background. Ricci's in on the 1-2 pocket. Leaves that disappointing 2-1. Looks like he had that one going. Going to have to get the ball to deflect off into the 7, maybe. Chouinard has a 2-pinner. Front pin there is the 2. Nope. Oh! Missed opportunity there for Dan the Man. He's at 36 through 3 with 1 spare. Ricci with that 9 is at now at 43 through 4. Put him in. 46, 43. A little. Sedan's picked up 3 of those. 13 pins that Jeff Walsh took from his teammate. Ricci back in the pocket. Leaves the back row minus the skate pin. Another 2-1 this time. Time it's the 6-9 on the right 7. Piece of wood might fly over there. Ricci goes first. He's got some wood to play with too, and he does, and he takes the 10 late. That's a nice spare. It was too deep. It was just a little too deep for Danny to pull that one off. So Ricci, Maki with a 53 and a ball. Dan Danny with a 56 and a ball. So they close, pick up three pins, but there are two balls left there. So it's a 10-pin lead, and both Jeff and Mark, as they start the six, will have a bonus ball. Keith Beaupre now moves over to lane six. Keith, who has averaged 117.4. We're in the playoffs here. He is the wild card here. His scores have ranged from 88 to 156, I kid you not, in the last three rounds. He will put together, you see, he throws the ball consistently, 40 miles an hour. And he can really rack up the strikes and the big fills. Both men are open in the sixth. Jeff Walsh had a 4 on his fill, so the lead is now 14. Plus Mark Ricci's bonus ball. Keith picks back two more of those with his 10 versus the 8. Lead is now 12. Beaupre with 61 in the 6th. Lines up. Boom! Oh, that's a beautiful thing. Walsh is in the pocket. A lot of 2-1 leaves. Not saying it's a trend. So far, a lot of 2-1 leaves today. Beaupre with the 7-8. Oh, looked like he wanted to hit the tip of that wood. Walsh swings it over. Nice. Plays the wood. A spare for Walsh. That is his second. He had a spare in the second. This is first on the back half. He's had a lot of tens. He's had 4 tens, an 8 and a 9. Beaupre looking for his second strike. Oh, sorry, I misread that. It's Beaupre who has 2 spares. It's Walsh who has 3 spares and a strike. 5 on the fill for Walsh. He's at 91, 21 over through 7. Spare for Beaupre. That is his. All right. That'll be an 8 for Walsh. He's at 99. Beaupre now at 81 in the 8th. Working on this bonus ball. Tough lead. He's got the hay bale, the bundle of 5. Walsh coming in right from the right side, leaves a 3-1 across the little pull on the head pin maybe. Second ball in the 9th. 1 for Beaupre. He raises that finger. All right, that'll be a 6. 3 more there. 108 to 92 in this pair. That's a 16-pin difference. Remember, Dan has a 3-pin lead, but Mark Ricci has a ball. So 13 is the difference now, plus a ball for the team from Riverwalk. Okay, second ball here in the 10th box. We're in the first of 5. Oh, what? What a carry on the, got it all the way to the 10. Both gentlemen with spares. Keith, the difficulty on Beaupre's shot. Guys that are throwing 25, 30 miles an hour don't make that shot, I'm afraid. That is not in my arsenal. I don't think about that one. Hit on the inside, taking out all the pins across. Okay. Bill of 8, so 18 in the 10th for Beaupre helps things. But we'll 20 from Jeff Walsh as he throws his strike on the spare. Bill That is a 128 start for Jeff Walsh, a 110 for Keith Beaupre. Now bowling on lane six, Dan Chouinard. This is the sixth frame. He was open in the fifth. Pops out three on the right. Mark Ricci in the bonus, comes across into the 1-2 pocket. Leaves the 5 and 7. Chouinard takes his second ball to match that. Both gentlemen with the 5-7. Ricci on his second ball. And we'll settle for a 9. And Marky Pins finds room on the left side to miss that without going in the channel. .70 through the sixth frame in the first string for Ricci. .65 for Chouinard. A 23-pin lead for the team from Riverwalk. Very early going here. We're just finishing up the first of five strings. And Danny pulls it off with a side saddle. 3-1. Using a lot of wood in the sidewalls. That's his second spare. He's been pinning very nicely. Ricci gets the wood to carry the 6 and the 9, and then the with a little help from the sidewall on the 10. That's his third spare. Saw that right to left spinning ball, 6 on the fill. A lot of connected wood for Dan. A lot of late action. Oh, a reset on the head pin. It moved forward, leaned back. Chouinard misses his spare opportunity. All right, that's a 5 fill. It finally settled down. 85 through 7. No magic there for Mark Ricci. Another 10. For Dan, that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 tens in this game. 10 players off and win. He has 2 spares. He has 1 9. He's left 1 pin on the deck, Dan has. Mark Ricci has left 3. As we clear the lane on number 5, the pin came forward. Dan Chouinard with his first ball in the 9th. A lot of good late action here. It's a fast house. The plates are clean. You can see from the roll, another. And look at that, very late. The 5 is the last to fall for Ricci. That's his first strike. Second strike of the game. His partner started the game off. Jeff Walsh with a strike in the first. Oh, 2 out of 3. Ain't good when you're making trying for triangle. Chouinard settles for a 9 there. Starting the 10th. Mark Ricci with a 104 plus these 2 balls. Chouinard with a 100. Oh, very thin hit on the head pin. Leaves 6. And Ricci has a very makeable 1-3-10. Chouinard clears out four of those. It'll be open. Ricci can't quite drive it back to the corner. And another 10 for Dan, who had two spares and six tens in that string. Marky finishes with a 122, a very consistent, he has a, one of the, I told you that Beaupre has the largest variance. Marky, I saw so many of his games at 121, 120, 122 in this case. Anyway, he and his partner put their heads together for a 250 there. And both Dan Chouinard and Keith Beaupre had 110s. So we have an early 30-pin lead. If we could put the score up officially. I'm just going to put the official score up for people.
All right, Jeff, come on, man.
Walsh is straight through at a spread eagle, but he clipped two of the wings. Hey, six for Beaupre. So there's your score, 250 to 220 after one. Both bowlers open in the first. So Keith and Dan both put up 110s, but Jeff and Marky both were in the 120s. They now have an early 30-pin lead. Make that 33 as Beaupre settles for a 7 in the first here. Walsh with the 10. We're just starting the second string, second of five. He just joined us. $2,400 NEKO NKOUT doubles. We started with 32 teams. These are the last four. A 1-4 for Beaupre with wood between. Walsh has a wing and a triangle. Boy, he gave it a look. Beautiful. That's the way to wreck that one. Oh! So a spare for Beaupre. He looks to take a chunk out of that 30, what is now a 32-pin lead. The team from Riverwalk. Walsh continues to pound the pockets. And Keith punches through and takes four on that fill. Leads down to 28 now. Walsh is open in the third. Beaupre needs to flip the head pin here. That has a chance. Third ball is wide for Walsh. He's at 28 through 3, and that's for a 10 for Beaupre. He's at 31 through 3. 27-pin lead for Jeff Walsh and Mark Ricci. We're in the top of the second. Five-string match up here at Lakeside Lanes in Manchester. Oh, look at that. It just evaporated. Everything, you missed the head pin. Everything else evaporated behind that two pin. What could have, for a normal mortal, might have been a half Worcester. Clocked Beaupre several times, three times, and each one of his strikes was over 40 miles an hour. One of the rare bowlers to reach that level. Another one on the stand to my right is Josh Daly here to watch the competition. Boom! Right in the face, back to the curtain, second spare. For Beaupre. And Walsh has to settle for a 7. He's at 35. He's yet to mark in the second. Try to follow up his 128 start. Beaupre, there he goes again. Only the 4-pin remains. Helpful wood probably on the left. Oh, what? Not a big Walsh. That was the Kaliri. The wood goes. 3 spares. He's got 60 in a ball to sit down. He does. And Walsh has a 44. So he led his team in the first. Now Mark Ricci's going to have to try to bring him back. So 16 pins came off the lead. It's now a 14-pin lead for the team from Riverwalk. They posted 128 and a 122 for 250 total in the first. Both gentlemen from Metro posted 110s. Keith Beaupre just put together a nice side. That's the 5-7 with wood for Ricci. Chouinard is on the Brooklyn side with that one. Everything cooked out to the right very nicely for him there. Ricci trying to get that one to slide back. His ball moves left to right. It's hard to shoot it back left, back right to left with that ball. Good pinning 10. 3 objects and a 10 for Markey. 1 object and a strike for Dan Chouinard. See, Danny only averages 0.35. He averages a strike every third game of the matches I've seen him play in. About 20 in my database. There he is. Okay, little puller on that one. 6 on the first ball. He has another in the bonus. Ricci. This spare. Oh, beautiful conversion on the check mark. Spare on strike for Dan Chouinard. That 14-pin lead now down to 4. And with Ricci taking a 6, we'll say it is all square. It is now all square. And Dan Chouinard has a ball in his hand. Nice 8 drop for. Okay, but with that, Phil, we now have a lead change. Our first of the match, as Chouinard and Beaupre have overcome the 30 pin deficit from the first string. Ricci has something to say about that right away. Spares for both gentlemen. That's 3 in a row for Chouinard. The first of the second string for Ricci. He's at 26 plus this ball. Danny right now at 47 in a ball in the third. That's 17 over already plus the ball. A 17 over bowler, if he completed the match with all 10s, would have a 117. Disappointing 5 on that. He's in the pocket. And a 6 fill for Dan. He's got the 3-1. See if he can keep his streak alive. That's a high difficulty shot. Oh, Ricci gets the hay bale to fall. And Chouinard's streak is over. He's open in the fourth as he chops the creep in. And an 8 in the fourth. So So at 61, he's 21 over through four here in the second. Markey is at 41 plus this ball. Remember, Keith Beaupre put up a 60 plus. And picked up 16 pins. For the team from Metro. Nice, that's gonna be a strike! And the 10 is the last to fall on that one. That's his second strike, he's laughing. Like I said, he averages one every third game. Spare man. Nice spare. Speaking of which, the side saddle with wood goes for Ricci. He'll sit down with a 58 and a ball, 71 and two balls for Dan Chouinard. That 13. So we are. There is now a one pin lead. It's a one pin lead. We have another lead change. The team of Walsh and Ricci have a one pin nominal lead, which will change in just a moment because Keith Beaupre is in the bonus. There it goes. So it's a five pin lead for the team from Metro. It's a six. That's a 66 half to close the books on the first half for Beaupre. Blasts out the head pin. Leaves the 210. Oh my goodness, he clipped it. That difficult. It's like the half Worcester, but it's the 4 and 2 that you get sometimes when the 10 pin clips. Walsh, high difficulty, very, very difficult spare there. That was his first. He needed that one. All right. So that 5 pin lead drops down to 3 because of Keith's 8. Jeff Walsh in the bonus. 2. The lead is now down to 1. Beaupre and Chouinard now leading by 1. Midway through the second string. Hard to call that a chop. Oh, again, going for that after a half Worcester. You play that one on the inside. Try to get the ball to clear out the corner. Walsh couldn't get there 2 in a row. He'll settle for a 7. 8 for Beaupre. The lead is now 2, by my reckoning, unofficially. Two pin lead for the team from Metro as Beaupre smashes through for a 8 drop. Oh, everything's coming back. Walsh looked like he was having the four horsemen, but they fell nicely for him there. You can see them laying on the deck. Perfect execution. The ball jumped up. But the wood carried through. Both men with a spare in the 8. For Walsh, that was his second, both in the backside here. For Beaupre, he's got 3 in this side. Oh boy, another 9 drop in the bonus. And 8. So another pin game there for the team from Metro. We're in the late in the second string of 5. On another one. The 5th spare for Beaupre. Another spare for Walsh. Oh boy, he's at 91 in the ball through 9. Walsh is. His fills have not been spectacular. Beaupre now at 111 and a ball, 21 over through 9. First ball of the 10th frame. Oh, there it goes again. The 7 is shaking. And this thing. Oh, Walsh is through the middle there. That's a 4 fill. Tough on the fills for Walsh in this one. He's got 95. As our NEKO KnockOut tournament director, Nick Zappaletto, comes out and grabs that deadwood. See him coming back. Round of applause for Freshie. In the face. Beaupre finishing with three spares in a row as a six mark game. Walsh struggles with a six on the spread eagle. So Jeff, despite having three marks in that one, had a 101. Beaupre picks one. All right, so very respectable though. It's all that is a 131 for Keith Beaupre. He got hot in that one. Six spares there. Fills of 1, 9, 9, 6, 9, and 4 for Beaupre. Beaupre. We're in the bottom of the second here. Five string match for $2,400 on the line. Ricci bites out the middle, he's a 3-2. Chouinard with a 2-1. Oh, what did that? The ball jumped left. The ball jumped left directly off of the 6-10. The wood was up against the 6. It just made an elastic. I told you he uses 2 6 balls. The lighter balls will bounce like that sometimes. But it came all the way across and took out the 7-pin. Unlikely spare for Chouinard. Remember, he had a strike. So that spare is on the strike. That's a 10 for Mark Ricci, 72 through 6. Dan Chouinard at 91 and a ball. The match is even up to the point of this match. So that difference of 19 pins plus this bonus for 6. It's now a 25 pin difference. The lead has swung by 55 points during the second. And there's Ricci with a good response there. He leaves 9 drop, leaving the 4 pin. Chouinard looking for magic again. Doesn't find it this time. Single pin for Ricci. He's got. With a 9, goes to 106. He's 36 over in the second string. And there it was. Third 10 to go with 3 spares for Ricci, but he's at 82, 12 over. Dan Chouinard putting on a show though. He's 36 over. 2 strikes and 3 spares in this one. He leaves himself a diamond. Right side, fronted by the 3-pin. Ricci leaves the rails. He got it off the wall. That's the way they tell you to do it. Use the wall. Try to drive those pins into the wall because the box doesn't go so easily. Chouinard with his 4th spare to go with the 2 strikes. Ricci looking to try to keep pace. He got it! What a shot for Mark Ricci! Oh my goodness, I did not see that action coming. So spares in the 8th for both. lead is now 24. Chouinard knocks out 7 off the head pin. And he's matched. Both men off head pin, leave 7. Chouinard's coming in hard. Oh, the wood got in his way. Blocked that pin action from taking out the 7. Reaching for the spare. He's got it. On the outside, he plasters the 3 of them. And Chouinard will settle for a 9. He's at 132, 42 over. 42 over through 9. Ricci at 109 and a ball. Again, the match, other than this game, is completely tied. As Keith Beaupre won by 30 pins in the second. Oh, that's 2. 2 for the fill. So Ricci is now at 21 over. Like I said, he's 122 in the first. He's been very consistent in scoring. And he turns it on. Yeah, come on! Never dropped much below that 120, 122 line, though. Another 10 for Dan. What a good 142 for Chouinard. And with that 9, that's a 120 for Mark Ricci. So 22 is the difference here. Team Metro has taken the lead. There was a 52 pin swing on that second string. .273 for the Metro team of Keith Beaupre and Dan Chouinard. .221. We'll show you that score. Oh, there's Jeff Walsh coming right back like he did in the first with the strike. The 5 was the last to fall. Beaupre pushing him hard, gets the left side to fall. He's got the 6-10 in the corner. Hey Josh, can you get the score and show it to people so those weren't listening? Beaupre executes perfectly his spare. Go right now. Both men in the bonus. Yep, let's go. Here's the score for those looking at home. All right, Jeff Walsh setting up. Looking for the double. He gets the check mark instead. He's got another bonus, though. Beaupre shakes that 4-7. Doesn't get him. Oh. No love from the right side on that. Beaupre with his second spare in a row, and his ball is coming right back. Ten there for Walsh. He started with a strike and had that 8 fill, so he's at 28. Keith, with his 2 spares, also is at 28, but he has a bonus ball. The lead is now 22 pins for the Metro. 8 drop, 7-10 remain. Beaupre misses the head pin by a whisker. Grabs 4. So the lead now is 26. No crossover there for Walsh. He's Beaupre on the 4 horsemen plus 2. He got them all. My goodness. What a shot. That's the second one of those where he's had the 4 horsemen plus at least 2 other pins that it executed like that. It's see why. Once you learn how to throw that fast, it can be hard to stop. Things like that start happening. Okay, 1, 7, 9, 10 left for Walsh. And 6 fall on that third spare in a row from Beaupre. He's at 48 already, 18 over through 3. Nope, wasn't there. That's good for. That's a 9 for Walsh. He's at 46. Beaupre will settle for an 8. He's open for the first time. He has 56. So. He's added 10 pins, Beaupre has, to the Metro League. It's now 32. We're in the top of the third. Nice crossover 8 drop. Beaupre slips, throws it off left. Chops through on the 4. Walsh all over the pair. Sits down with his second mark. Remember, he started that with a strike. He's got 56 in the ball. Beaupre. Big out here. This is as big as any spare. Still. Got 7 pins still standing up there. Oh, and he chops again, but we got the head pin at least. So that's a 6. And a 62. A 62 half for Keith Beaupre. 56 in a ball. Jeff Walsh closed that up. So it's still, remember, we started with a 22 pin lead for Team Metro. It's now moved to 28, but that with that ball, it's nominally still about the same as it was. Mark Ricci now starting on lane 6. Lays it down just a little right on the corner. In the quarter pin. And Chouinard! Shaking. No, that's the 8 pin ball for him. Big candy bar in front of it, though. Ricci missed that by centimeter or less. Spare for Dan as he starts his third string. Very much the way he started his second. Chouinard came up big with a 142 in the second string. Go along with Keith Beaupre's 131. Put the team, the Metro team up. Ricci has the 178. Pins are still falling. Still thinking about falling. He's got just the 3 pin. With one down at its feet. That was a 9 fill for Bernard. Nope. Something didn't go right there. His feet were left. Ball came right. He had to avoid it. I think he was trying to aim. That's what it was. He was trying to shoot it in and avoid that cap that you saw. So disappointing 9, but Marky also with a disappointing 7 in that frame. Half Worcester down route 28. Chouinard back in his pocket. Leaves the Nina, the N-shaped leave, consisting of the 7, 4, 8, 5. Oh, Marky finds just the spot. Here it is. Pip, pip, pip. All of them go. The only way to reliably make that one. What a shot with his nice right-to-left ball that was set up nicely for him. Second spare for Chouinard. And that'll be an 8-3. Both of these teams, teammates are good friends. Ricci and Walsh met each other as children. Their dads were good buddies. They lived in West Somerville together. They bowled a lot. As children, they've been bowling their whole lives together. Dan and Keith also. Good buddies. They participated in a lot of events together. Send their fact sheets to me. That was a 6 fill for Dan on his second spare. He's already 14 over. Looking to clear that. The back goes. Yes, the sleeper pin falls as well. The 9 taken out by a piece of wood coming off the right side wall. That was a 10 for Ricci. First ball, the 5th. Crane coming up. We're in the 3rd. Bottom, finishing at the top of the 3rd here. Good. Goodbye to all but the 6 pin. Chouinard is back in the pocket. I think we're going to see scores in the 1200s here today. Both of these teams are putting up some pretty big numbers. A lot of late pin action. The house is fast. There's a spare for Ricci. Chouinard's going to need to try to send it across, and he does! Oh my goodness, that was his 4th spare in the first half. Also had 2 9 drops, 71 and a ball for Chouinard. 44 and a ball for Mark Ricci. Difference there is 27. Hey, Jeff's in the bonus here. So Keith Beaupre starts with a strike in the 6th frame here. It's a big bonus ball for Walsh. He's got a 7, good fill, but a tough lead. Good veteran move there to send the wood back to the right. Got it to clear the 6 pin, but not the 10. All right, that's a 9. Jeff Walsh is at 72, 12 over through 6. Keith Beaupre at 72 plus 2 balls. Doesn't matter if he hit the pin, the head pin. He hit the side of other pins. Leaves himself the 1-2-4. Beaupre still in the bonus. Put a spare on that strike. Oh! The ball came back. Danced around. Kind of encircled the pair that was left behind. Chops that for a 9. And that was in the channel. That's a 9 for Jeff Walsh. So he's at 81. Keith Beaupre at 89 for 7. That's 19 over, heading for a 119 if you were to 10 out. Beaupre has posted scores of 110 and 131. We're in the 3rd. He's starting to really come alive. Missing and leaving very easy, makeable spares. In this case, he's got the 1-3 backed up by a little bit of piece of wood. Oh, just popped that head pin. Ball slipping to send it. Good 10 for Keith. 8. For Walsh, she's at 89, 9 over. Okay, misfire on the on lane 5. Well, they reset. We'll recap. We'll look at the scores. We're in the the ninth box of the third frame. We've reached the midpoint now. We're bowling 5 strings. Keith Beaupre and Dan Chouinard put together strings of 220, scores of 220 and 273 in the first two. That's 493. Meanwhile, Jeff Walsh and Mark Ricci are at 471. Those 22 pins coming into this third string. Keith leads by 10. And Dan is putting up big numbers in the front. He's working with a 71 and a ball. And has a, so we're looking at about a 50 pin difference now in the match. Beaupre is open. Walsh sends it. Clobbered the 4, but the 7 wouldn't cooperate. That was for a 10. And a 9 for Walsh. 109 through 9 for Keith Beaupre. 98 through 9 for Jeff Walsh. First ball. 10th frame. We're in the third string. Walsh. God, he wants that to fall. Yes, he does. The 5. Oh, but the 5 fell for him, but now it's standing 10. Block in half of his look at the 10. Keith tries to dig the 4, which he can't. He's going to have to play the ball off the wall. Nope. That's what, the only thing you can do, really. Roadblock. 10 for Beaupre. 10 for Walsh. That's a 119 for Keith Beaupre and a 108 for Jeff Walsh. At 11, so the lead now stands at 33 officially. Dan Chouinard working on some to add to that. Chouinard in the bonus, 8. 9 fall. And friendly wood across the 7. That one got away from Mark. Carries through off the cap. That's the 5th spare in this third. And there we go. the nine drop spare for Ricci. It's really, that was a strike ball, I guess. Marky was in the bonus. What was that one? Nine drop for Chouinard. Puts him at 99 in the 6th. Another. Mark keeps pace with a 19 of his own. Nope, the cap doesn't work this time. Ricci for the bear. Left slap. Okay, 3 times in a row he's gone to the cap. Twice it worked. Once for a spare, once for 10. That is 109 through 7. So he's already 39 over. So he gets 10s in the last 3 boxes. Chouinard will have a 139. Mark Ricci at 73. He's three over, so all 10s would leave him with a 103. That's pretty much where the match stands. Chouinard is not missing. Oh, and that 10 falls very late for him and leaves three pieces of wood, all of which should cover that 7 pin. Wow. That was a strange one. That poked the two out as Chouinard completes. That was his sixth spare. Ricci. Very unusual lead there. Poked the two out. Knocked the 5 and the 10 and the. Now took out the 3. Okay, he's got the 1. Plus 4 in the back. Boy, that's a tough out. Tough 6. So he goes under 79. 79 in the 8th. Ricci. Chouinard, 39 over. Make it a statement here. Oh! Make it 4. That was a 2, Phil. So he's now 41 over. Little breathing room, but not much. More late tumbling pins. Ricci has a roadblock in front of his triangle. You can see it, I don't know, it's facing, the ball's going to come off left. Yep, no chance really with that. The ball would have had to hit the wall and come back and do the work. Chouinard with a 9. That was for a 10. Nice work on the triangle there. Ricci badly wants a mark in the 10th. Keep his score in triple digits. 9-10, there it is. The 7 was the last to fall. That is his third strike of this match. Already at 130 in the 9th. He's looking for a 150 if he can get 10 on his first. On his first two. Ricci has an interesting look here at the 9-10 with 2 pieces of wood. The second piece would not cover the 10, but if you can get both to drive 10. Here it comes. Both of them go. Both of them go. That's the mark he wanted. Chouinard with a strike to go on top of his 6 spares. Looking to post a 150 here. Okay. He's up to 149. Ricci. That's a good 9, Phil, for keeps him in at 108. And there's the 150 for nice game for Dan Chouinard. He has a 142 and a 150 back to back. If we were playing 3, that would be 400 series. He's at 402 after 3. Ricci with his 108 is at 350. Jeff Walsh also had a 108. Beaupre had a 119 there. Jeff Walsh starts off head pin with a 7 drop. Keith Beaupre We'll also have seven. There's our score. Jeff working on his spare. I'll show it to you. Oh, nice. Oh my God, he slapped it in the face and it didn't fall down. Beaupre takes out. What a cocked hat triangle of a leave that was. And that'll be a nine for Walsh. So the score now is at 762 to 687. That is a 75 pin lead. Nice lead action. Keith gets seven in his spare. And Walsh is on the board with his first mark of the fourth. We're in the top of the fourth now. Oh, Beaupre sends one left, but can't pick up the corner. And that'll be a nine. 26 through two for Beaupre. 19 and a ball for Walsh. Match stands plus 75 for Team Metro, the Beaupre and Dan Chouinard team. Five in the fill for Walsh. That's a spare. So, you get those? Beaupre is open in the third. No lead is safe with these guys. Nine for Keith. Two spares in a row for Walsh. He's at 34 plus this ball. For three. We're in the fourth. There's a nine drop. And half Worcester left. Sense a little momentum shift. Oh, he thought he missed it. He thought he missed it and he caught just the edge. Look at him wiping his brow there. He's happy with that. Three spares in a row for Walsh. Beaupre punches through the head pin. Third ball here. Big out. Five pin standing. And there's another four off the lead. Lead is now down to 63 pins. Walsh in the bonus. Trying to bite away some more. Nope. Three in the corner. 60 pin difference now. Beaupre back. Is that one. The three and one leave off of what feels like a strike ball. Walsh. Four marks in a row. All spares. Started with a nine and will sit down with 66 and a ball coming. Keith Beaupre puts up a 51. He started with a spare and then went 9, 9, 6, 10. 51. Now Dan Chouinard, who had 402 in his first three, stands up on lane five. Mark Ricci delivers first on lane six. Oh, gone! That is strike number five, I believe, for Chouinard. We'll go back and do the official stats later. Well above his average. And what a pickup for Ricci. That was a statement. Had to hit the side. Couldn't hit the cap. I hit the side of that pin that was just staring right at him with the eye like that. And then the ball had to carry out to the corner for the 10. He had to have enough juice on it to clear the 5. Nice Woolworth there. Right in the pocket. And that's gone. The 5 was the last to fall. And a little 2-1 baby split for Dan Chouinard. Still in the bonus. Mark Ricci with a strike on spare. Not dead yet. There it is. Goodness gracious. Like he's shooting pool. What a shot. So a spare on strike versus a strike on spare. For this pair, we're in the top of the fourth. $2,400 on the line here. Oh, God. And he's got the strike, though, so he's going to have a second ball in that bonus. Got the whole sine wave of pins left there. With no break. 7 pins standing in the back rows. Grabs 3 of them. Chouinard with another 2-1. Nope, not this time. So 7 in his fill, and he'll be open in the third. Ricci, who ended up with 6 in his strike fill, settles for an 8. He's at 44 through 3. 47 for Dan Chouinard. So two bowlers of 17 and 14 over respectively through 3 boxes. Remember, Jeff Walsh had a big 66 in a ball going. We started this string. Danny toys with another strike. Watch his posting. He put his 5 of 7 from Lakeside last week up. He pulled a 595. He's going to do better than that today. But he's open. He's open here. He misses a single pinner. I was going to say he's over 75% accuracy in his good games. He can drop down in the 60s when it's not going right for him. Same could be said of Ricci. Ricci throws a little more velocity though. A little less side action. Okay, both. All right. A 10 and a 9 in the fourth. Dan's at 57, 17 over. Marky's at 53, he's 13 over. Granny's teeth. And cocked hat lead for Chouinard. Pins are facing the right way though. Good for Danny. Not sure how Mark can play this one. Just like that. Grabs 2 in the middle. Oh. Chouinard said something. It was just a little too deep. All right, so it's 61.5 for Ricci. And with that 10, a 67.5 for Chouinard. Another 6, so that's 81, but lead is now 66 minus this ball. It's a 66 pin lead minus this ball from Jeff. And we're in the fourth. Mm-hmm. And that'll be a Then two. That's a three.
What?
That's a two. That's a two fill for. So it's 64 pins right now. Team Metro, yes. Team Metro is up 64. And Keith will be open. His ball's still bouncing around back there, though. You never know what he'll do. Freshy, back to clear pins again. Freshy the pin board. I want to thank him for organizing this effort. He goes deep under the hood, sends the ball back, declares the pin to be live, live wood. You don't want to throw into a ball though. So Keith evidently will. See if he plays it off the wood in the middle. Yep, he does. Tries for the tip. It's an eight. Hey, nice clear there. That's it. That was for a 10. Big out there though. Every league bowler knows that feeling when you get six or more pins. Four more pins standing in front of you with your third ball in your hand. Beaupre leaves the horseman. Walsh just a little bit flush. Two and two. His partner. Tell him to think about the wood on the left. Slamming it into the wall. Like that. Yep. Third ball here in the seventh box. We're in the fourth string. Keith Beaupre and Dan Chouinard holding on to a 60-pin lead, 60-plus pin lead. Walsh, all over the pocket, has the 5-8 covered, wood in the middle, boom, oh boy, that's as fast as you'll see the four horses in a post go, and Walsh matches suit. For Keith, that was his second spare in this, the fourth string. He's coming off of strings of 110, 131, and 119. Drop seven on the bonus. Seven on the bonus match by Walt. That's a 24 over. Keith said six over. So there's Walsh doing his part to bite away at that lead. Every pin critical now. Okay, 114 to 95 through 9 here in the fourth of five strings. The $2,400 NEKO KnockOut New England KnockOut Doubles Championship from Lakeside Lanes in Manchester, New Hampshire. Keith Beaupre, off head pin right. Oh, goodbye. That was, I believe, Walsh's third strike of this affair. One that he needed. Oh boy! What? fierce response in the 3-2. Got the, well, a little bit of frustration in that one. See if that one covers the 42 mile an hour barrier. Keith in the bonus here. The, oh, 1-5. 2 on that film. Walsh is off. But he's, he gets a little. That's a, he's got 2 bonus balls, so. Still 6 sand out there. Good way to get 4 of them. 132 for Jeff Walsh when they needed it. 107 for Keith. Beaupre. Told you he'd have variance. No one gets hotter and no one can get a little colder sometimes than the fastball. I like that. Okay, we're in the bottom of the 4th. There's now a 50-pin lead for Team Metro. Dan Chouinard can lighten it up. Oh.
Okay. So
neither bowler here in the 6th. Was working on a mark, so they were both open in the 5th. Ricci with his 2nd ball. A lot of wood. What a bounce, what a play. He read that one like a scholar. So with that spare, and 6 pins on the bonus, if Ricci can make it, it'll be a 50. That'll erase the lead that Chouinard had. It'll be a 50-pin difference. We have seen 50-pin swings in every one of these strings. So, hang on to your tray tables, boys and girls. With that 8 draw, it's now, and with Chouinard staying open, lead is under 50 now. Does it go? Does it go? No. Wood was not favorable for the 9 pin on that one. Okay, 10-10 in the 7th. Chouinard has 87 through the 7th. That's 17 over. Ricci at 89. 19 pins over. The match stands at 48 pins. Metro Bowl in the lead. Parallel pins for Chouinard. See what he does. Yeah, he tried to get that to skip back. Got it! He got it! I wouldn't have thought to go inside like that. What a play. That was a 10 for Dan. He's put up quite a few. He's got a run of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 tens in a row, Chouinard does. Has a 97 through 8. Pokes it through for a 3-3. He's got the triangle and eagle wing. Like kind of the curveballer's equivalent of a spread eagle. Okay, tough. Okay, another 3-1. Six in the fill for Mark. He brings the lead down to 42 pins. No that time. Third ball here from Ricci. No, it's a seven. And an eight. Oh. This is the 10th box. We're in the bottom of the 4th. This will be the last frame for our final frame. Chouinard knocked down 6. Ricci coming across. Needs a triangle. Just a little off his head pin now. His run of tens ended with that 8 in the 9th. For the spare, Ricci, he's got! Oh! That is odd. That's a 114 for Dan. Back to Eric. And Mark's back in his zone, the 122 zone. That was a 254 for the Riverwalk team. Jeff Walsh with the 132. Mark Ricci with the 122. They picked up some ground there. 221 for Team Metro. That was a 33-pin swing. It was 75 before. Let's see what the official score says. There it is. 983 to 941. So it's a 42-pin difference. Thank you. As we start the last, Jeff Walsh. We've seen 42-pin swings 3 times in this game. So don't give it up. There it is. Beaupre. I believe the 4 was the last to fall on that one. Okay, Walsh can't convert. And keep calling it like that. You feel the bottom of your feet, even when you're standing 30 feet behind him. That was a good ball, but jumped up over the wood for an 8. Goodbye. Nope. Oh, what a wreck. Oh, my goodness. 5-9 were standing after the hammer went through, and then the pin action off the left wall then for a double. Keith, vote praise. Jumping, he's incredible energy right now. 2,400 dollars on the line here. He's coming through real big. Looking for 3. There it is. That's a triple to start the 5th string. Oh my goodness! Only seen this once before live, where a bowler starts with a triple. Jeff, who had a 3 on his spare, now has 31 through 3. Keith, Beaupre, with 3 strikes in a row. That's a good miss with 5. Perfect. All right. Leaves the little wishbone there, the little triangle supposed to be head pin. That's a 6 fill on the last pair, a 26 fill on the second. So it's a 71 through 3 and 78 with that 7. 78 through 4. Just picked up another 36 pins. Right when the lead was starting to erode. Okay, now he's got a lot of cortisone pulsing in his veins. Got to find out what to do with it. Heard Sensei once say, get those butterflies marching in formation. Look at that ball. Wow. He could play outside on the four horsemen all day. There's no worry that it's going to carry, that the energy is enough to carry to the fourth pin. All right. Still highly jacked. He's got 87 as he sits down through 5. Keith Beaupre does a 56 with 2 spares for Jeff Walsh when we were watching all that. Walsh had a spare in the fourth for the 7th fill. But that is a 31-pin pickup, adding to that 42-pin lead. So we're back to 73-pin difference. Top of the 5th here, 5th and final act. Ooh, Chouinard coming back to life again with the 9 drop. Ricci has the 1-7, 2 pieces of wood on the left. Just have to hit the left side there. Yep, good job, good job. And roadblock for Chouinard. Okay, here's the situation. Mark Ricci is in the second frame of the 5th string. This is a 5-string match. His team now trails by 72. Mounting the beginning of his comeback here. In the bonus, he picks up 6, so that lead is now 66 pins. And Chouinard is off head pin, takes out the left side. Ricci's looks makeable. If that stuff is connected, he's got the triangle in one, but everything's connected. Yep, it was. 2 spares in a row. And that lead that if you just joined us, you missed Keith Beaupre start the 5th string with a triple. A triple strike, leading to an 87 half. With Team Metro, what was at the time a 73 pin lead. Mark Ricci trying to dig his way back out. He's got 2 spares in a row, go up against Dan Chouinard's 2-9. Not out of reach. Okay. 5 more on the bonus there. Difficult spare leave inch. Chouinard gets the 9 drop. Oh, like he's playing on the outside. There's the spare. That's a big one for Dan, who started with his first with a 402 in his first 3 strings. Helped put Team Metro out in the lead. Back down just a bit to the 114 in the 4th. Trying to get himself back together. Ricci, who has put up scores of 122, 120, 108, and 122. 9 over. Through 3 boxes in the final. Oh boy. Yeah, that was the spell he wanted for that problem. Third ball is coming up here. We're at the top of the fifth at 10. Puts Ricci at 49 through 4. And Dan's 10 puts him at 43. So. Six pins the difference, yeah. Just 11 more boxes to play. Need to start biting those off. Snake bit there. Walsh standing in the wings. He's just talking about needing strikes now. 59 for Ricci, 53 for Chouinard. The lead is 66. It was 42 going into the fifth box, but Keith Beaupre put up a triple. And here he is with his first in the sixth. Walsh. He's the four horsemen in the far post. Sleeper back there, too. Oh! The new physics. Oh, he needed that one. Shaking his head, nope. That'll be a 9. Said that was in the channel. Oh boy, that's his fourth strike of this string. And a 5 fill off the pocket shot frustrates Walsh. Got the bundle, the hay bale, as I like to call it. Nope. Sent the pin off into the wall, but it got trapped in the gutter. 4 and 8. It's at 79 through 7. Beaupre trying to eliminate any doubt. Oh my. He's off the head pin. He's just the 1, 3, 6. And the 179 for Walsh. A lot of wood to help. Okay, both bowlers open here in the. That's a 10. Is at 125 through 8. That's 45 over. So he puts up 2 more 10s here. He's going to have a 165. Both of Keith had the most variance of any bowler in this tournament on their way through there. They defeated Mark Yurd and Aaron Quinn, Mike. Kane and Ricci, Dean Sullivan and Norm Pelletier, and Lou Garcharna and Ed Woodside. Now they're looking to put the step on the team of Ricci and Walsh. Ricci's giving him hell for making his first spare of the match. Go with four strikes. He's at 135 and a ball in the ninth. Oh boy. Oh boy. Five stands fast, but that nine fill helps. Oh, why you can't? All right. Spare is good for Walsh. That's a 154 for Beaupre. What a great four strikes and a spare for 154. And four in the fill for Walsh.
He guessed the four and I got the other.
That's a 110. That's another 110 for him. What's that? What does that add up to? That was a 621 for Keith Beaupre. Nothing bigger than that 154 at the end. He picked up another 44 pins, added to the 42 pin leads, 66. 66 is the difference. There's a 10 for Ricci. Lead is down to about 65 now. Well, I go better than that. Dan leaves three. It's like the 7, 8, and the 6 on the right. Ricci. Well, I don't know if you wanted that last spin to fall. Oh my goodness! How do you make that? That is the new physics. Right to left ball jumped across and picked out the 7 and 8. Off the face of the 6. And no such love for Mark. You hear a full recap from Mark of this match on Ripping the Rack, Tuesday, Candlepin special edition. Dan Chouinard, 72 and a ball through 7. Marky pins at 78. Seven. They have three more to play. Lead is unofficially 64 pins right now. Congratulations on running a great tournament.
Thank you for doing this. Got compliments on the commentary.
It's been excellent. We're live now, but obviously they're bowling out the string, 66 pins. I think everybody realizes it's. Are you going to be handing over the prize ones? Okay, we'll stick with that. Oh, that's a thick stack of cash. Hey.
Yeah, that's awesome. Yeah, we're going to take a trip to Encore. So. Yeah.
Talking to Nick DeVolato, Ricci as he's known. Josh Daly came back. What did you think? You see, what do you think about Beaupre's triple in the fifth to eliminate any doubt there?
When his first ball's gone, man, forget it.
Well, no bowler had a wider variance in the matches in this bracket. He ranged from 88 to 156.
Wow,
and you can see.
Amazing, though. You know, he keep with it. How unpredictable it's going.
And boy, it was good to see him like that. Oh yeah.
He won NEKO years ago.
He didn't tell me that on his fact sheet. Okay. Tell us more about the NEKO Championship. What is it? It's an older institution.
Yeah.
I mean, you obviously set up from others before you.
So we started this up, and I had a bunch of people help me get this off the ground years ago. And it worked. The first bracket we had 48 bowlers. We had to kind of improvise. We did like a top six, and then we chopped it down from there. But, took a hiatus, whatever. There was no rhyme or reason. I just took a hiatus and kicked it out when COVID started. And now we got the ladies NEKO going on.
Yeah, there's been a lot of action there.
We're gonna be doing a summer singles NEKO.
Okay.
We'll probably start taking signups for that.
I am thrilled every time I come out and watch these guys. You know, anytime you want, Ricci, give me the call. We'd love to, like, so people can follow it better. It's what I love doing more than anything at home is watching these matches. It's hard once you keep score yourself. It's hard to follow what's happening. And there's a lot of action. Like your match, the match you guys had in the first round. Oh my goodness! That's about as high as my adrenaline's ever gotten when I wasn't bowling myself.
I gotta tell you, I appreciate you taking time out of your day to do this. You know, I'm sure all the listeners appreciate it too.
Well, when do you get to call a triple like Beaupre's in the fifth to, you know, to clinch a $2,400 purse like that?
Yeah.
We don't see much of that. It's Marky. Nice job, Marky. Yeah.
Very exciting, man.
All right, let's get the final tallies. I think they're in the bonus now. Dan finishes his last with a 107. Oh! Marky imagining what it would be like needing that triple to win, but he can't pull it off. He's the five and dime off his strike. Oh, okay. All right. Eight to the fill there. That's a 126 for Ricci. 107. Put the official scores up in just a minute, and we're gonna. You guys stand out there. They're already handing out the cash. $2,400 in that package for Dan Chouinard and Keith Beaupre. $1,200 go to the second place. Remember, 64 bowlers started, 32 teams. Everybody put in for that. It is a tremendous amount. You see. The final tally in both respects.
I can't wait to read your analysis on that.
I think there was something about the triple in the fifth that might be critical. All right, so here's our final tally. We had a 1244 for Team Metro to 1177 for Mark, for Team Riverwalk. From congratulations to everybody who participated. Thanks to everybody who was involved. All 64 of you. I'm Bob Lee. This is from Spread Eagle Productions. We'll be putting this up on YouTube later on so you can archive it. Good day.